Good morning to all of you. So we'll practice some programs in array so that we'll clearly understand how array is used in programs. So once again, I'm repeating the same program which I discussed in the previous video, that is write a C program to read and print an array. So I want to make you very simple the programs on array. Whenever you are doing programs on array, first you should remember that in any array program, whenever you declare an array, along with that array you should also require an index variable I and a size variable n. So you might be getting confused, what is this size again? Once more, this is the actual size that we allocated, and out of these we'll ask user how many is going to use, and that we are going to store it in n. So this is what we should have a clear picture: array along with array, index variable and size. So this is common for all the programs in array. So remember, whenever you do declare an array, along with array you should have index variable and size. That is compulsory. Then we'll read the size first. In any array program, first thing is you have to read the size. So read the size means what? N. Now here A is array, but where I and n are your normal variables. Okay, so read the size n. N means normal variables. So how do you read a normal variable? In the same way you have to read it. Then afterwards read the array. So here we have to use for loop. For reading the size, no need of for loop, is a normal variable. So we directly do as usual, we do it in our normal programs. But the third point is read array. For this we have to use a for loop. Then apply the logic on array. So again there is a concept of array, you have to use for loop. Then print the array if required. Here also we have to use for loop. It means whenever you are using the array variable, whether it is for reading or logic or printing, compulsory they have to be done by using for loop, because array means there will be a repetition of doing the same work by changing the indexes. So you will be reading, it means scanf is same, you will have to read the a of 0, a of 1, a of 2. So by using for loop we can write single scanf that will be repeated. Instead of saying a of 0, a of 1, a of 2, we write simply a of I, as the loop is repeating for I values. So I value will keep on changing. When I value is 0, you will be reading a of 0. When I value is 1, you will be reading a of 1. So it becomes very simple. So once again I'm repeating, whenever you are doing programs in array, these are the 5 points you have to remember. At the time of declaration, along with array variable, you should declare the normal variables I and n, where I we are using for representing indexes, and whereas n is the size that user is requirement on motto. So actually we are providing 30 memories for him. Out of 30, how many is going to use? That is called as n, that is user size. Then after declaring those array variable, index variable and size variable, immediately first duty is to read the size, next to read the elements into the array, next apply the logic, then print the array. So this is the normal scenario for all the array programs. So whenever you are reading array, applying the logic, printing array, for loop is compulsory. Okay, now let us see how we are going to write a program. So as I said, we declare an integer array. It means we are going to store numbers in the array, that is integer numbers, int a of 30, I, n. Then read size, it means we should ask the user how many memories he want to use. So instead of asking like this, we will ask simply enter the size of array. Then he is going to enter some number, that number we are going to store it in a variable n. So first read size. So remember, whenever I say read size, one printf, one scanf. Okay, then the second third task is read array. It means how to read array. So whenever you're reading array, it means it is also a scanf statement, na? Before scanf we have to give a clear message for it, yes or no? So that message is this. We should ask the user to enter values into array. How many values? These many values. So do you know value of n? No. That is where enter percentile d. Here you can say elements or values. Normally whenever we are talking about array, we will be saying elements. So it is your convenient. You can say elements or values. So here we are asking the user to enter values into array. So we are asking how many elements? N elements. But n means what, do you know? No. That is where whatever that is stored in memory n, that value I have to display. It means that many number of values that user has to enter. I am giving a clear message for the user. Enter percentile d elements into array. How many elements? N. It means in this percentile d place, whatever the n value that is holding, that should be displayed here. For example, if the user has given n value as 5, here you will get the message like this. Enter 5 elements into array. It means 5 different values you should enter. By seeing that message, user will enter 5 different values, and that 5 different values has to be stored in array. So one by one, first A of 0, first number should be stored in A of 0, second number should be stored in A of 1, and so on. So for that I am using a for loop to store values in the array. How? Your array index starts from 0, no? So 0 will be stored in I, and this I variable I will use it in scanf. So I is equal to 0, 0 less than n means true, then I will enter, then I will read that value which is entered by the user and store it in the position A of I. I is having what? 0. So A of 0. Then your I value will be updated. That is, I value becomes 1. Again, it will check 1 less than n or not. If it is true, then you are going to read A of I. Means I is changed to 1 now, then you are storing A of 1. In that way, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4, all will be read into the array. So here, after reading the elements into array, here we have to apply the logic. If it is required for this program, we don't have any logic, only we have to read and print. So now this program does not have any logic, we are not writing any logic. If at all you want to apply logic, again for that also we have to use for loop. Then printing the elements of the array. So this is read the size is finished, printf scanf, and then you have to read array. Read array means one printf, for loop, and inside the for loop scanf. So you just remember this pattern. Any program will, these two, 1, 2, 3, these three will be as usual. This is the first point, this is the second point, and this is the third point. These are the common steps for any array. Declaration, reading the size, reading the array will be common statements in any array program. So if you are practicing this, then almost half of the program for any array program will be the same. So declaration, reading the size, reading array elements. So apply the logic if at all it requires. Again, logic should be applied by using for loop, and then printing the elements of the array. So whenever you are printing, you have to say one message and say that this is the elements of array, no? So you are saying that the elements of array are, here you no need to mention that 5 elements of array are, because you are already showing them. So elements of array, while reading, you are asking enter percentile d elements. Why? Because user should know how many values you are asking. So enter percentile d, but while showing, you no need to mention percentile d, simply say elements of array are, and then by using for loop just write printf and then say a of I. All the elements of array will be displayed. So it is very similar to scanf. In scanf also we use the same for loop. While printing also we are using the same for loop. It means whether reading or writing, you are using the same indexes or not. So the for loop will be the same. Only the difference is here it is scanf, here we are printing, that is why printf. And remaining everything is same. So this is the normal program of reading and printing an array. So this will be your output of the program. This will be your output of the program will be like this. Enter size of the array. First you will get this message. By seeing this message, the user has given a number called 6. It means we will give a number 6. It means 6 memories we are using. Already 30 memories are created. Out of 30 we are going to use 0, 6. 6 means what are the indexes that we are going to use? 0th index, 1st index, 2nd index, 3rd index, 4th index, and
fifth index. We will be using only till fifth index. But actually, there will be 0 to how many indexes? The last index will be 29, not 30. So already 0 to 29 indexes memories are created. But out of 0 to 29, we are giving facility to the user how many he wants to use. It's not compulsory that odd 29 must be used. So that is the reason we are using enter the size of array, and that 6 which he enter will be stored in a memory n. So before giving the output, this is the memories that are created at the time of declaration. So if you look at here, when I declared int a of 30 comma I comma n, this is how the memories are allocated. An array with 30 memories are allocated, and I and n are normal variables. They are declared, these are the memories that are created separately. Now you see this array is starting indexes is the array index is started with 0 and continued. And what will be the last index? You just tell me, what is the array I declared? A of 30, na? Then what will be the last index? Not 30, 29, because we are counting from 0. So there are 30 blocks, but starting from 0, that is where the last index is 29, where I and n are a normal variables like we have done in our normal programs. So if you come here, when I give the size as 6, this 6 will be stored in n, because here we have written enter size of array. For that scanf, what I have written? N. It means whatever the value I give, that value is stored in a memory n, like this. Then I am asking, if you see here, enter percentile d elements into array, and in percentile d place whatever the n that is having, that has to be displayed here. So what is in n here now? 6. It means you will get a message like this: enter 6 elements into array. So now you, I think you understood why did I place percentile d, because you should, user should have a clarity that how many elements we are expecting. Then we will give 6 values like this, one, any numbers randomly, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more number is missing. So I have given these values. It means 6 different values I have given. In that way, first value will be stored in this memory, second value will be stored in this memory. It means 20 will be stored in this memory, 14 will be stored in this memory. What is the third value? 3 will be stored in second index. Then what is the fourth value? 1, that will be stored in third index. What is the next value? 2 in fourth index. Next value? 5 in the fifth index. See how many memories I filled? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it or not? Then it has stopped. Fine. So this is how the memories are filled. And what is this I means? If you see the program here, what did I say for I is equal to 0? When I say for I is equal to 0, your I value is initially 0. Then I am asking to test the condition, 0 less than 6, true. Then in scanf I used a of I, na? It means your scanf is storing which memory? A of 0, that is here. Then again your I value will be updated with 1. This is what. Then again 1 less than 6, true. In scanf you said a of I, na? Now as your I value is 1, then you are storing that element in a of 1, then I value is updated. It means your I in the for loop is representing the indexes. With the help of that index variable, you are filling the array. So this is how your array is read. And similarly, after reading, you have printed the array. That is, elements of array are the same values will be printed. So this is one small program about array. We'll see remaining programs after half an hour.